town. Tonight we have an all-star group led by a great young trumpet player. He's from this area and he's traveled the world. We're delighted to have him back in town and leading this group. We have his latest CD, and there's a lot of treats in store for us, so I'm going to go right to the music and let that do the speaking for me. Without any further ado, let's give a warm Cleveland and Nighttown welcome to Mr. Dominic Farinacci.
Thank you very much. So tonight, we have a lot of different things happening, to say the least. This is the low-budget touring band over here. So, but we have some of the greatest artists in the world playing tonight. And in fact, a wonderful, very special guest from the other side of the world. Many different special things to tell you about. I just want to say a special thank you to the YPO, the Young Presidents Organization of Cleveland, for helping to host this event tonight. So thank you, Scott, and everyone. So we're going to get to a lot of different music.
He's not playing right now.
Please help me welcome... Never mind. Okay, good. We're just going to get into it. Thank you.
Second chorus.
much. Let me just make some quick introductions here. I know it's going to take the entire evening with everyone. And we have more artists in case these guys don't sound good. But so far, it's wonderful. Guy's a dear friend who comes from Las Vegas. Surprisingly, he's talented. Actually comes from Florida via California, but is currently residing in Las Vegas. And not only is one of the great vibraphone players in the world, and there's only two of them, he's also a wonderful composer. He writes music, musical director for great Cirque du Soleil productions and all different kinds of great things that are happening around the world. Just an all-around brilliant musician. This is Christian Tambor on vibraphone. On bass, we grew up playing together, and then he moved to China for 13 years, and then just came back a couple years ago, and he helped to really kind of create a real jazz scene out in Shanghai. And bad dude, and now he's back in town. We're so glad he's here. This is EJ Parker on bass. Not to get to the student section of the band. So on right here. So on guitar, we've been spending the past couple days together. Such a brilliant young musician is currently at Oberlin Conservatory. This is the great Ben Cruz on guitar. And on drums, also at Oberlin, man. Yeah, dude, it's been a great time playing with you, man. This is Michael O'Day on drums. And the veteran of the band, not just because he's the oldest. No, sorry, just kidding, Jamie. I mean, not really, but you know. Yeah. He's one of the true legends of music in any part of this world, this planet Earth as we know it. If you heard any Paul Simon's music, Sting's music, all different kinds of incredible artists, you know Jamie's work from over the decades. He's from right here in Cleveland. He teaches out at Oberlin Conservatory, and I call him the Moses of jazz education, because like everywhere I go, basically every artist I've met over the years or I asked to join my band has come in some way from Jamie and learning from Jamie, and we're so blessed to have him. This is Jamie Haddad on percussion. We'd like to invite a very special guest to the stage who I just had the pleasure of meeting today and is in town for a very special project we'll tell you about in a bit. And he's actually originally from Afghanistan, and Jamie introduced me to him. He said, you got to check this guy out because of this project we're working on. And we wanted him to come up to the stage and play these beautiful instruments over here. Please welcome, via California though, but originally from out in Afghanistan, this is Mr. Salar Nader. Where is he at? Salar. I just want Jamie to say a couple words about him because he's a special, special dude, man. Yeah. No, not you. I'm saying the next talk. That's right. If you can figure out how to get there, that's good.
Jamie, why don't you just fight
me? Thank you. Yeah. Well, first of all, when Dominic said he was doing this project involving veterans of war from Afghanistan, people have served. And he mentioned Afghanistan. Well, I have a band called Under One Sun, and you know, if you're trying to make a creative music project, a contemporary music project, using people who are really, really masterful on their instruments from other countries, chances are they don't know anything about jazz, for one. And you know, or care to learn about it, or you know, have the facility to do it. And as soon as I heard Salar, I met Salar and some whack gig we did up in the
2007
mountains.
2007 in the Pyrenees.
In the Pyrenees. And I didn't have any idea who this guy was. There was 20,000 people on a hillside in this ski resort, and he basically grooved the whole place by himself. Yeah. And I was like, who is this guy, you know? So we've since become friends, and I have nothing but respect for the amount of time and energy he puts into his instrument. He's a true, true master of his trade. And Salar, I'm blessed to have you here, and we're lucky to have you, so thanks for being here, brother.
Thanks for having me.
My pleasure, Salar Nader. So we're going to play a song that I wrote during my time living in Doha, Qatar. That's an effort to kind of bring together my own interpretation of the sounds of that region of the world. It was an interesting place, and we'd like to feature Salar and some other artists on this tune. This is called Doha Blues, yes.
This is called a hammer.
That's a hammer.
We tune the tabla, you know, with the hammer, so I just need a C. There you go. This instrument was in Portugal 3 days ago, San Francisco last night, and today in Cleveland, so it's being a little, holding a little rebellion.
Yeah, it's jet lag. First class of coach.
Yeah. Cockpit. Why did
you
stop
letting me see? This is the song, by the way. We hope you enjoy it. Thank you, sir.
Have a good night.
Thanks.
We'll leave the lights on.
We'll let it get.
Happy hours tomorrow.
Thank you.
That we brought to Cleveland for the first time just about a couple months ago, and we're so glad that she's come back here in our special project and in town, and we can bring her to Night Town tonight. Please welcome the lovely vocalist from New York City, Miss Chanel John. And my heavy triplet thing, I put a spell on it.
Thank you. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, off.
I wish it worked like that.
Shabu, you do your own. I said, don't let me.
We'd like to feature Christian now on this solo piece of his that he's been working on for months to prepare for here at Nighttown. Thank you, Christian.
Vibraphone,
oh, yeah. Great. One thing I love about Christian, we spent so many years together playing, and it's great to reconnect. He kind of got this idea from me, but takes a lot of popular current songs, or I think more familiar songs, and kind of turns them around, twists them around, and does a real cool thing with them. You did get that from, were you doing that before I was doing it?
Before I met you.
Oh, okay. Anyways, did, yeah, but that's great. So, what was I going to say? Oh, yeah, because that last song we played, you know, Duke Ellington, it don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. So, you know, I talked about education before, that's like, you know, growing up playing jazz, you learn that kind of stuff, you know, and all the great jazz artists, and try to do that and emulate all of our heroes from back in the day. So it's great to have a solid foundation in that, and that's also kind of cool to go in a little different direction. So check this out, what Christian is going to play for you. It's a beautiful piece entitled...
Thank you so much for such a nice introduction. Yeah, all right. Tune entitled, this is great. This is for the family. This is a tune entitled Smells Like Teen Spirit.
All right. Yeah. son. That's great. Well, thank you, Christian. So look, I know this is probably the first time in history that anybody has ever taken a break after a solo vibraphone solo. Usually everyone leaves. But we're gonna take just a couple moments. Kind of read. And we have a couple very special guests who are going to come up, and we're going to do a couple things in a preview of this show that we're working on. It's part of the reason why all of these great artists are here in town. So we have a lot more music to get to, and we're going to take literally like 10 minutes, and we'll be back here. So the good thing is, I have albums over here, and I only have 14 left, and Christian is not on it. But, if you really like his playing, then yeah, he's on the 13th track of it, so you can check it out. There's only 11. But great. So anyway, we'll be back in just about 10 minutes. Thank you so much. Another round of applause for the band. It's a great band. Thank you, thank you. We'll see you in a moment.
How are you doing? I'm Mike Farinacci.
All right, thank you very much.
Mike Farinacci.
Yeah.
You know this guy.
Yeah.
So we have a couple of special things for you. First, I want to get started. I invite a very special guest up to the stage to sit in with us. For those of you who have seen shows before and know a little bit about the stuff I love to do, you know, I'm very passionate about education and working with younger musicians. And in fact, every musician on this bandstand not only is a wonderful artist, but also a great educator. And that's kind of part of the thing about jazz, you know. You learn to play and you become a lifetime learner and always trying to improve. And then you figure out a way to kind of bring the younger generation along your gigs when they get older. There's one in particular that I had the pleasure of meeting who I'd like to invite up. He's in the 8th grade at Shaker Middle School. And and he sounds great. He's a wonderful alto player, and he's in this new band I put together through Spirit of the Groove, celebrating Carl and Lewis Stokes this year. And it's a band called the Stokes Legacy Jazz Orchestra under Tri-C Jazz Fest. And he joined the band. He's doing great, and I invited him up. I'd like to invite him up to play one song with us. Please welcome, in the 8th grade, wonderful alto saxophone player, Mr. Thomas Schinnebeck, to the stage.
Thank you.
Settlement program, which is a wonderful program. We're so glad to have him involved in the Tri-C programs as well. You know, there's so much talent around town, and it's really humbling to be able to work with a lot of students. Now, of course, I can't take any credit for what he sounds like, because he sounded like that when he came into the band. And this band, again, it's called the Stokes Legacy Jazz Orchestra. We're going to be performing all around town April 11th for Tri-C Education Days, and also for the Jazz Fest in June. And it's a multi-tiered kind of educational concept. So we have artists from 8th grade to high school, to college students, to veteran, you know, professionals around the community, all working together in the same band so that we all could learn from each other. And it's a real life professional situation. That's really the best way to learn, in addition to having the schooling stuff. So we're really excited about that. It represents 14 different schools from around the area. Can we turn off the fan again? Sorry. Thank you. Now, before we get to this special piece, I want to play a song that was one of the favorite songs of somebody who was very dear to me, who just passed away, and who was equally passionate about education here in Cleveland, and who helped to make all the wonderful educational programs happen. And the center that's named after him, I'm speaking of Tommy LaPuma. Over the years, you know, he's one of the greatest producers of all time. He's produced, you know, Barbra Streisand, The Way We Were, Natalie Cole, Unforgettable, David Sanborn, Miles Davis, Paul McCartney, goes on and on. George Benson, Breezin, legendary dude. And he sold like over 75 million albums, and the last album we did, he produced it, and I always used to joke with him and say, man, now you're going to sell 75 million in one. His business has changed. But he's become he was such a close mentor and a dear friend, and unfortunately passed a couple weeks ago, but he's left us such a beautiful legacy in terms of music and the striving to be the best we can be, and also in terms of education, and really dedicated his past years to education here in Cleveland. So anyway, I don't know where I was going with that. I wanted to say thank you all to the YPO, the Young Presidents Organization, for not only hosting this event tonight, but also hosting a very special event we did with Tommy just a couple months ago, January 30th. And me, Tommy, and Terry Bontrembly got to to speak at this wonderful event. It was because you guys put this together and made it happen that we got to see Tommy one last time a couple months ago. He was right here in Cleveland. And, yeah, so he will be missed, but every note we play is really dedicated to that spirit. And I'd like to play now a song from this latest album we did together that was one of his favorite songs that for me to play, and helped me to build a beautiful arrangement around it. It's written by the great Diane Reeves, one of my favorite vocalists. And I know Stacy loves it, so. Yes.
I'm giving the high thumb to Terry.
Yeah, we got to play at a Tommy's birthday party celebration last year. Diana Krall was there, and Dr. John, Leon Russell, Al Jarreau. Damn. Thank you, Terry, for making this happen, by the way, wherever you are. Anyway, a lot of special things happening at Jazz Fest and all that. And okay, so we'd like to play this song. It's called Tango, although it's not a tango. But anyway, it's a beautiful melody. And Terry introduced me to opera back in the day when I was a kid. And I used to love it, still love it, and lost a lot of friends because of that. But everyone was checking out Vanilla Ice. And Terry was like, check out Puccini. Yeah. Try to approach it like this. Try to approach this song like an opera aria. So I'd like to play this for you now. Yeah, Tango. Thank you. I think next time I want to hire an alto saxophone player.
That would be cheaper.
Well, actually.
Thomas's price just went up. Okay. Great. So I got one. Four and one. One, two, three.
dude. I mean, and I really appreciate, I just want to say, I really appreciate James, your buddy Mark. There's Mark over here. They served together in Afghanistan. He came in from New York. James, do you mind just telling them, sorry, then we'll go. Do you mind telling them just a little bit about what we're trying to accomplish here with this program?
Yeah, so we want to do a couple things here. I know for me, the big thing is kind of letting veterans know that are going through that hard time that's a temporary thing for most people. I think the general narrative that you see is that, you know, you come back, you experience something like that. If you spend a moment going through those issues, a lot of guys see that as a life sentence. They're going to be dealing with that for the rest of their lives. And it's not really true. What I was talking about, the helicopter, that happened after my first deployment. And that was the only time that ever happened to that extent. And then it slowly went away. I don't think guys are hearing that. And there's plenty of vets out there doing amazing things. I don't think that there's enough light put on that. So it's part of why we're doing this. And then the other part is kind of bridging the gap between civilians and veterans, kind of facilitating dialogue and having these discussions. So that's what it's about to me. And I'm excited about growing this, taking it on tour. Yeah, and thanks again, guys, for the reception here. That was awesome.
We're going to send everyone off with a local song with all of us. It's going to be brief, and we want to say goodnight. But before that, I just want to thank a couple people and tell you just a quick announcement. Doing a very special event. Where's Mark and Karen?
Over here.
Jeff, okay, Jaffe. So they run a wonderful program called Shaken with Laughter. And we're doing, anybody know about it?
Yeah.
It's a wonderful foundation they created in support of Parkinson's. And it's actually Karen's birthday, right?
Tomorrow.
Happy birthday, Karen. They've been doing wonderful events. They raised almost $1 million, right? Over the past few years. That's right. We're going to take it over the top this year. So after you leave here, go buy tickets to this show. This great benefit. When is it? Sorry, I'm playing on
September
it.
But 9th. Yeah.
September 9th. Chanel's going to be there as well, the whole band. And it's going to be at the Ohio Theater. And the benefit for Shaken with Laughter in support of Parkinson's. Thank you so much for putting that together. Really quickly, I want to thank everyone in the band. This is Christian Tambor, DJ Parker, Ben Cruz, Salah Renata, Jamie Haddad, Michael O'Day. You heard Will Blaze earlier. Where's Will over there? Will, man. Great hold of this band. Beautiful. And Chanel Johns. How about a round of applause for Thomas Schiffbeck back there, man? Terry Von Tremmen, of course, my wonderful manager, came in to be production manager to help put all this whole thing together, this whole thing that we're filming. And also, I want to say hello to a good friend who runs a wonderful organization in the Catskills called Catskill Jazz Factory, which brings young artists there to and commissions them to write brand new arrangements, and then puts the show together and tours it all around the world. He's a real serious guy in our world in terms of promoting young talent. This is Mr. Pierce Playfair over here. Yeah. Thanks. Okay. And thank you all so much. It's been a pleasure. And we're going to send you off here. Chanel and Will, you guys around? Good? Do some blues.
I'll tell you something, though. So I quit my man. I'm a
Yeah.
Christmas.
If you quit me, baby, you won't see me anymore.
Yeah, well, I know you love me, baby.
Sure
so I got to treat you right. Yeah. I know you love me, baby. Got to treat you right.
Yeah, you do, baby.
That if I treat you right, give me good love and all your life.